right. Let's try this again. Because if you are not aware, this morning there was the huge announcement that DC fandom is actually going to be split up into two separate parts. So this Saturday we are still getting DC fandom Hall of Heroes, but then in September we'll be getting a separate event called DC fandom Explore the Multiverse. So this is going to be interesting. This Saturday, the Hall of Heroes event is basically going to be like the bigger stuff, like all the movies and only like two TV shows. But it's definitely going to be interesting. And if you watch my channel, then you may have noticed that I did a video just like this a couple days ago where I broke down the schedule. But now there's an entirely different schedule here because half the content is missing. And while I do believe that it was a good decision to split this up because that was a lot of content for 24 hours, at the same time, it feels like the hype level has kind of gone down now, especially because, like, looking at the schedule here, there's a lot of filler stuff in here, like stuff that I'm not going to want to watch, like Legacy of the Bat and, like, Chris Daughtry performance, and then there's, like, a documentary-type thing about the Joker. Like, I'm not going to watch things like that. I'm mainly going to stick to the actual movies and TV shows. So like in between those panels, there's just a lot of empty space there. Whereas when the TV shows were in here and what we're getting in September was in here, there was a lot more. It was like there was something new like every couple minutes, and it was crazy. And sure, it was complicated and confusing, but this just seems like there's not much going on now at this point. But that doesn't mean I'm any less excited for this because the big panels are happening this Saturday. So let's go ahead and break them down. And if you want to go check these panels out for yourself, just go on over to dcfandom.com and you can create your own schedule and everything so you'll know when everything is. But let's start off with Wonder Woman 1984. This will be the very first panel in the Hall of Heroes, starting it off just like it was supposed to in the original schedule. This will be starting at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you're in the Pacific time, I think it's like 10 a.m. So there's that. But during this panel, Wonder Woman 1984 stars Gal Gadot, Chris Pine, Kristen Wiig, and Pedro Pascal, and director, co-writer, producer Patty Jenkins join forces with Brazilian host Errico Borgo and Aline Denise to celebrate the fans in a big way. They will answer questions from fans from all over the world, talk fan art and cosplay, and reveal an all-new sneak peek at the upcoming film, plus a few more surprises. And this will end up being a 25-minute panel, so definitely very exciting. Hopefully we'll get our first official look at Cheetah during this panel. I'm assuming what that sneak peek is our first official look at that, because they've really been saving that like forever now, so I'm excited for that. But after that panel, we do have, like, right after that, because that panel is 25 minutes, it starts at 1 o'clock, so then it gets over at 1:25, and then the next panel starts at exactly 1:25, and that will be the Warner Brothers Games Montreal announcement panel. And if you've been following the news the past couple days, then you know that they've been teasing a new Batman game announcement, and I'm assuming that's what this panel is going to be all about. It's going to be about the new Batman Gotham Knights game, where the Court of Owls are going to be the main villains, and it's super exciting. So I'm excited for this. But like I said, it starts at 1:25. It's a 20-minute panel, and the description says, "Gamers, you won't want to miss this first look at an exciting new game and Q&A with its developers." So that's definitely very exciting. Hopefully we find out some information about that game and, you know, maybe even a trailer. I mean, that'd be pretty cool. But now let's move on over to Introducing Flash panel, where this is basically the Flash movie panel, which is really interesting. And it's only 10 minutes, which, as I said in my other schedule breakdown, is really interesting because this is going to be a 101 style conversation with the Flash filmmakers Andy Muschietti and Barbara Muschietti, star Ezra Miller, and screenwriter Christina Hodson, and they will give fans a speedy rundown on the first ever Flash feature film. And in the trailer today for the DC Fandom Hall of Heroes event, it was showing a bunch of clips of parts of this event, and one of the clips showed director Andy Muschietti, and he was saying, like, we might have something to show you, or, like, there's something we can show you or something. So it looks like we'll be getting some kind of first look at something, whether that's just concept art, whether it's casting, whether it's, like, I don't even know what else. But I'm definitely excited for that. But what I'm excited for even more, and I think this is probably going to be my favorite panel, or at least the one I'm looking forward to the most, and that is the Suicide Squad, which will start at 2:55. So there is some other panel in between the Flash panel and this one, but it's not about any movie or TV show, so I'm leaving those panels out of the video because the video is already going to be pretty long. But the Suicide Squad panel starts at 2:55 p.m. and will be a 30-minute panel. What else would you expect from the Suicide Squad but the ultimate elimination game? First up, writer-director James Gunn takes on fan questions, then brings out Task Force X for a fast-paced, no-holds-barred squad showdown that tests every team member's squad knowledge and survival skills. So, definitely exciting. This sounds like it's going to be a cool panel, really fun because they're actually playing a game and it's going to be kind of like Jeopardy. Plus, they have a hilarious cast for that film, so that's going to be awesome. But then we have a whole bunch of other random, basically, filler panels that don't have anything to do with movies or TV that I'm not going to go over. But I will give a few shout-outs here. We have Legacy of the Bat at 4 o'clock. Females of Color within the DC Universe starts at 3:40. Chris Daughtry performance, I have no idea why that's in here, but that starts at 4:20. The Joker Put on a Happy Face starts at 4:30. Jim Lee Portfolio Review DC Supervillain Fan Art, 4:35. Surprise DC Comics Panel, I might check that one out. But that starts at 4:45. And then there's also I'm Batman, The Voices Behind the Cowl. That starts at 5:10. But now to one of the panels everyone is looking forward to the most. And that is the Snyder Cut of Justice League, which, yes, that is what it's officially called here. So it looks like that's the official title because back at, I think it was Justice Con when Zack Snyder was talking about the Snyder Cut, he was saying that they were trying to figure out what the title was going to be called because when this was officially announced, it was called like Zack Snyder's Justice League, but it looks like it will officially be called the Snyder Cut of Justice League, which I love because, I mean, that's what it is. It is the Snyder Cut of Justice League, and that was the whole movement, was release the Snyder Cut. So it's going to be cool that that's what it's going to be officially called. But this starts at 5:30 and will be a 25-minute panel where Zack Snyder fields questions from fans and a few surprise guests as he discusses his eagerly awaited upcoming cut of the 2017 feature film and the movement that made it happen. So definitely going to be exciting. I'm looking forward to seeing who those surprise guests are. Maybe Henry Cavill, Ben Affleck, Ray Fisher, I don't know, none of them were announced for the official cast list, maybe even Jason Momoa, but if Jason Momoa isn't here for the Aquaman panel, then I doubt he'll be here for the Snyder Cut panel, although he has been a big supporter of it, so who knows. But then we move on to one of two TV panels during this event on Saturday, and that is The Flash. This is definitely going to be very exciting. This starts at 5:54 p.m. and this will be a 40-minute panel, and actually the description is not here, but from what I can remember when I read it last time, it's going to basically be about talking about what happened in season 6, and then they're going to give a few teases of what's happening in season 7, and then I think they're also going to go back and look at one of the past episodes as well. It was like a noir episode or something like that. So that's cool, and I'm definitely looking forward to that. But then we move on to another really cool one I'm looking forward to, which will introduce The Rock into the DC Universe with Black Adam, starting at 6:10 p.m. It's going to be a great panel, and it's going to be 15 minutes long. All right, so star of the first ever Black Adam feature film, Dwayne Johnson sets the stage for the story and tone of the new movie with a fan's first Q&A and a few surprises in this 15-minute panel. So I'm definitely really looking forward to that one. I'd say probably the two I'm looking forward to the most out of this whole thing on Saturday is the Suicide Squad and Black Adam, because we don't really know that much about those movies officially, but from what we've heard about them, they're going to be really epic movies. So I'm definitely looking forward to everything going on there. And I love how it says a few surprises, so maybe we'll hopefully get some casting announcements. So far, we only know that obviously The Rock. Yeah, I keep saying his name wrong. Like, in one video, I called him The Rick. Like, I don't know why I have trouble saying that, but The Rock is playing Black Adam. And then we also know that Noah Centineo is going to be playing Adam Smasher, member of the JSA. But then also in the past couple days, there's been rumors of Alexander Skarsgård being cast as Hawkman. So maybe we'll find out something about that. It'll either be debunked or confirmed here, hopefully. But I'm definitely looking forward to that. But then the other TV show panel that we have is Titan. This will be starting at 6:50 p.m. And they are definitely going to have an interesting panel here where the description is actually missing for this. See, they need to get going on fixing this website here because some of the descriptions for these panels are missing. But from what I can remember, I think they're going to go over like the top Titans moments of both season 1 and season 2, and they're going to give a few teases for season 3, which should start actually filming rather soon as well, so that'll be interesting. I'm looking forward to that, but yeah, we'll see. Then we have the Aquaman panel starting at 7:05 p.m. This will only be a 10-minute panel, and like I said, Jason Momoa is not going to be part of this event at all. But it says Aquaman director James Wan and King Orm himself Patrick Wilson will take a deep dive into the world of Atlantis that Wan created, revealing their favorite behind-the-scenes moments from the largest DC movie ever. So it's pretty much just a look back at the first movie. Doesn't seem like we're going to be getting any teases or reveals about Aquaman 2, so that's a little disappointing, but it does definitely seem like it's going to be interesting, and I'm definitely going to check it out. But then we have an interesting one here, and this isn't specifically about a movie or a TV show. This is kind of just an extra filler fun thing in here, but I just wanted to add it in here in the video because there might be something to do with the Harley Quinn animated series. But this panel is called Ask Harley Quinn, and it will start at 7:15 and will go for 10 minutes. And the description says, she has gone toe-to-toe with Batman and the Justice League and taken down the Joker and the toughest villains of Gotham City. But at DC Fandom, Harley Quinn faces her toughest challenge yet, answering burning questions from DC's biggest fans in her own tell as it is, no BS style. So if you love the Harley Quinn animated series, then you cannot miss this panel. I don't know if there will be any actual reveals, but it'll be interesting. Still gonna check it out. So yeah, look forward to that if you are a huge Harley Quinn animated series fan. So stay tuned for that. But then after that, we have a Wonder Woman 80th celebration panel as well as another panel with Jim Lee. But then after that, at 7:40 p.m., we have the Shazam panel, which will see Zachary Levi, obviously the star of Shazam, and the cast. They're going to be kind of talking about the second movie, but they've been sworn to secrecy on the new script for the movie. So Zach and a few of his Shazam castmates will talk with Philippines' number one DC fan, Gino Guillamore, about what the next movie might be about, while commenting on everything from panels to the other Zach's cut, and even a few surprise guests drop in with a 10-minute panel. So I'm excited for that. Sounds like we'll be getting some teases for Shazam 2, but not anything really official. Plus, it's going to be interesting to see Zachary Levi talk about the Snyder Cut. You know, maybe we'll actually see him in there. I mean, I doubt we'll actually see him in the Snyder Cut, but that'd definitely be cool. Then moving on to the final two panels, starting off with Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League at 8:10 p.m. with a 10-minute panel. So this panel says, Will Arnett hosts the highly anticipated video game reveal from Rocksteady Studios, creators of the Batman Arkham franchise. So that's all the description says, but hopefully maybe we'll get a trailer, we'll get some more information about this game. But I'm definitely looking forward to this game. I think I'm actually looking forward to it more than the Batman game because, like, we've had so many Batman games, but this is going to be not only a Suicide Squad game, but Suicide Squad versus the Justice League. So just think of how insane that's going to be and how many characters we're going to get to play as in this game. So I'm really looking forward to that. But then we have the grand finale with the Batman panel starting at 8:30. And this will be a half hour panel, 30 minutes long. And it says, the Batman filmmaker Matt Reeves joins host and self-professed fangirl Aisha Tyler for a discussion of the upcoming film with a surprise or two for the fans. And in the actual trailer today, there was a clip of Matt Reeves saying, like, you know, I couldn't show up here and talk about the movie without showing you part of it. So there has been rumors also that we'll be getting some sort of teaser trailer here, like a 30-second teaser trailer. So I'm looking forward to that. Maybe a better look at some of the characters, like just the Batman suit, the Batmobile, a first look, whether it's concept art or actual photos of the Riddler and Catwoman and Penguin. So I'm really looking forward to all that. But that was the grand finale with the Batman. So that will be ending at 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So other than that, they're going to replay all of these panels three times. So I don't really know why they need to, because everything is going in order and nothing is happening at the same time. So if there's something you want to watch, you can pretty much just check it out when it's on, and you know, you don't have to worry about other things being on at the same time. But yeah, so I'm still very much excited for the Batman. The hype level has kind of gone down seeing how little content there actually is now, because, you know, going into this, like, especially with seeing the schedule last week, there was a buttload of content here, and it was going to be insane. But now there's a lot less. But like I said, I'm still excited for this. I'm still going to watch all these panels. But let me know down in the comments below, which of these panels are you looking forward to the most? What do you think of the big split with the two separate events now? So yeah, thanks so much for watching. Please drop a like if you enjoyed this video, and hit that subscribe button so I can keep you up to date on everything that goes on in the DC life.